Hey everybody, it's Lon Sybin, and we are back with our cord cutting and cord shaving series where we look at ways you can reduce the cost of bringing live television into your home. We can still use our cable company without their equipment, so we can save on rental fees, or we can get rid of the cable company altogether and bring in over-the-air content. And one platform we haven't spent a lot of time on recently is the Apple TV platform. And I just got done reviewing the new 4K box here, and I figured I would take a look at what some of the cord cutting and cord shaving solutions are available on the Apple TV platform, which we're going to explore today. Now, I do want to mention in the interest of full disclosure that one of the tuning devices that we use here in the house for all of this cord shaving stuff is made by a company called Silicon Dust. It's called the HD Home Run. They are an occasional sponsor here on the channel. They are not paying for this review, however. I also want to let you know that we're going to be looking at an app called Channels, and they provided me some free codes to try out their app here on both the Apple TV and on iOS devices. And we're also going to be taking a look at Plex, which we've talked about quite a bit in the past as well. And Plex is an occasional sponsor here on the channel too, but they're not sponsoring this video. So all the opinions you're about to hear are my own, and no one has reviewed this content before it was uploaded. And again, this is not a sponsored video. I do suggest you check out a video I recently uploaded about my entire setup so you can get a feel for the context of how all these different devices work together, specifically how the HD Home Run tuners work. In a nutshell, what I've got here on my network is an HD Home Run Prime in the closet. I have a cable card connected into it from my cable company, and it brings in all of my cable TV content and makes it available to anything that's compatible, including, in this case, the Apple TV, and it works really well, and I got all of Comcast's equipment out of the house, and I talk a lot more about that in that other video. So we're going to kick things off with the first app of the three we're going to look at, which is the Channels app, and this is something we looked at a little while ago, but they've made some additions to it that I think are worth talking about. So this costs $24.99 on the App Store. It works with your HD Home Run, and what you got here when you first load it up is the On Now guide, which gives you a bunch of thumbnails here about what's currently on TV. But I know a lot of people want a channel guide, a more traditional guide, and that's one thing that they bring to the mix here is an actual channel guide that you can scroll through like you might on your cable box. This is a patented thing. They don't own the patent to it, but they're clearly paying a licensing fee to get at it. So it's a more of a traditional interface than what you might have seen from some of the other things that we've looked at recently here on the channel, and it does seem to be working pretty nicely here. There's also a version for iOS, your iPad, and your iPhone. That version has a similar interface to what you see here on the TV screen. That version costs $14.99, but you buy it once and it works on all of your devices. So if you have multiple Apple TVs in the house, you spend $25 to start, it'll work on all the Apple TVs that you have. And if you want to watch something on one of these channels, you just click the button here and tune to the live TV and you're off and running. And there's also some time shifting that you can do while watching live TV. So for example, I can hit the pause button here and kind of rewind to earlier parts in the broadcast if I want to do that. So out of the box, a pretty useful app here with a very, very nice interface that feels very tightly integrated with the rest of what you might encounter on your Apple TV. Really slick, really nicely put together. Some nice filtering here too for narrowing things down by HD or SD. You can even set favorites on your HD Home Run device itself so that only the five or six channels you watch most often can appear on here. There's also some search functionality and some other things too. So all in, a really, really nice interface here, and definitely I think the best of the bunch right now as far as what you can find on the Apple TV platform. Now, what they've also done though recently is added in a DVR feature, and this DVR works a lot like the other DVRs we've looked at over the last couple of months in that you have to have something on your network to run the DVR software on. In my case, I'm using my WD MyCloud PR2100. That's the same device right now that's running my Plex server as well as my HD Home Run DVR server that we're using on the Android boxes. So this is another piece of software to install, but it works in a very similar fashion. So right now it's installed on my device. I'll show you some of the settings to it. I can go over here to my past recordings, for example, and if I want to load up Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood here, I can go ahead and just click watch and it will queue it up from the DVR server running on that WD MyCloud device. So it works pretty similar to how you see other things working. You can fast forward and rewind. You can also dig into that channel guide, for example, and set up things to record later. So maybe I want to watch, I don't know, BBC World News later this evening. I can click on that future thing that's coming up. I can record it. I also have the opportunity to create a season pass so every new episode gets recorded. And you have some other options here as well to do some padding on the broadcast before they start. So a lot of the basic DVR features are here on this one. They also have a pretty neat way of allowing you to watch things while they're still recording. So that's something you can do, of course, on the HD Home Run DVR natively. You can do it on here too. So if I click on Law and Order, it says, hey, you're currently recording it right now. Do you want to watch where you are live, or do you want to watch the beginning of it while I record the end? And I can, of course, watch the recording here. And you can see here this purple progress indicator gives me an idea as to how much I have available to me to watch. And then it's going to keep recording for the next 42 minutes or so until that show is over. So you can jump ahead, and then when you get to where it's live, it'll just start playing the live broadcast as it continues to record. It's a lot of nice time shifting features built into this, a pretty fully functional DVR in my opinion, and it seems to be working pretty nicely here on the platform. The DVR is not free. It's an additional $8 a month. That covers the cost of them bringing in this channel guide information. I would imagine some of the patent costs involved with it are also part of that. That's something that costs these developers money to provide to you, and that is why you have to pay that fee. The only other issue that I'm encountering at the moment with this is that it doesn't work on platforms other than the Apple platform. So the iPhone and the Apple TV and the iPad, for example, are the only places where this DVR currently works, although they do have a web version that you can log into both on your network and remotely to watch that content on any other device. Let me show you what that looks like. So here is the web version of their DVR, and you can see we've got the similar looking guide here on the web page. This will work on anything that has a web browser, and if I wanted to, for example, to tune into a channel here, we can go to the Weather Channel, and then I'll click on Watch Now, and it will start playing here. This is coming over the network from my, let me just turn the volume down here for a second. This is coming over the network from my WD MyCloud right now, and the server that runs this DVR works in a very similar way to what we've seen with Plex, in that it can transcode video. It's taking the large video it's getting over the cable transmission and making it smaller, so if I'm off-site, I can watch it at a more compressed and maybe lower resolution in order to work with a cellular network, for example. So it's able to do all of that real-time transcoding. And if you have a processor on the device that's running the server, it could be a computer or a NAS device like I have, as long as it's compatible with QuickSync, which is an Intel hardware encoding technology, it's on many chips, you'll get hardware encoding for this as well. So they've really done a lot of nice work making this work here. Of course, you could go full screen with this if you want. You can also stop that. You also have the ability to go back into your DVR recordings here and play back stuff that you've already recorded. So here's that Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood episode, and I can, of course, click Watch Now, and I'd be able to watch that remotely. And if you have the app running on your phone or on your tablet, you can access the server remotely through the app itself without having to go through that web interface to get there. So all your DVR recordings and all your live TV can be transcoded on the fly through your computer or whatever device you're using to serve content out, and you can watch it while you're on the road. I did a test with it earlier. I've got no signal down here in the basement with my cellular provider, but I did test it upstairs. I was able to successfully transcode a 1080i broadcast down to 720p at around 4 megabits per second, and it was able to sustain a pretty decent signal throughout as I was watching remotely without being on my local Wi-Fi. Pretty cool stuff. And it looks like the recording engine they have for this DVR is compatible with a number of different platforms, so Mac and Windows. If you got an old laptop or something kicking around, you can also use Docker if you're into that. Synology, QNAP, WD MyCloud, Netgear. They've got a pretty substantial compatibility list here that I think you'll find something that you've got kicking around the house to run that DVR server. So all in, the Channels app here looks pretty nice. Nice slick interface. It really integrates nicely with the Apple TV platform as well as the iPhone and iPad platforms too. A great app. We've looked at it in the past, and the DVR looks like it's maturing very nicely and working quite well. One thing I want to bring up, and I bring this up in all the videos that we do, is something called DRM that your cable provider might put on your channels. Where I am, Comcast just puts the DRM on HBO and Showtime and some of the premium networks, but some folks have cable systems that lock down everything. So even though you're paying for that cable subscription and getting the cable card, it still doesn't work with this configuration because the channels are marked as DRM'd and therefore don't work with a lot of these platforms. Channels does not yet support DRM content, but they are promising to do so in the future according to their FAQ. So if you are dealing with DRM across your entire cable system, probably not going to work for you right now, but it will work with cable systems like mine that don't DRM everything, as well as over-the-air broadcasts. So the next app on our tour is the InstaTV app, and this will work with your HD Home Run tuner just like the Channels app did, but it also works with the HD Home Run DVR. That's the same package we reviewed a number of times here on the channel and what I use as my primary DVR here in the house. So although Silicon Dust at the moment doesn't have a native client for their devices or DVR, InstaTV will work with the Silicon Dust hardware and their DVR software. And again, check out my prior videos to see more about that. So I can go through my recordings on here, for example, so I can play back this episode of Nova that I've got here, and it shows me all the different Nova recordings that I have stored. And I can load up extreme animal weapons here and then play it back. Now you'll notice here that it's not playing in full screen. And the reason it's not playing in full screen is because I haven't unlocked full screen playback for DVR recordings. That costs $15. So the app is free, but this is the kind of functionality you'll get with it. After you pay the $15, you can unlock for full screen playback and get it. The app also runs on the iPhone and iPad, but you do have to make a separate in-app purchase to get full screen playback on those devices as well. So let's quit out of here real quick, and we'll jump back to the rest of the interface here. And what we can also do is see what's on live TV. So I can go scroll down, for example, back to the Weather Channel here and play back the Weather Channel as it's currently airing. And we'll let that start going here. And I do have the ability to do some time shifting here, so I can pause the show here and rewind a little bit. There's a tiny little icon you have to navigate over to here to kind of zip back into the recording, and then you can rewind live TV if you want. The interface is not as intuitive as what you just saw on the Channels app or HD Home Run's own application for that matter, but it does give you the ability to have a single DVR system running on your network to be able to watch what you're looking to watch on here. The one thing I don't think this does as well, though, is setting up recordings that are happening in the future. So if I scroll down through all this stuff here, this is just the things that are currently on TV. I don't believe there's a way I can search for recording things later on. So I can play back recorded content, I can watch live content, but I can't set up new DVR recordings on here. I'd have to do that on Silicon Dust's own software first. I should also mention that the HD Home Run DVR software does cost $35 a year, and that pays for all of your program guide information and everything else to keep that software working, and you'll get updates, of course, as they make them on there. And the last option we're going to look at on this tour is Plex. And of course, we've talked about Plex quite a bit here on the channel, just about every month or so. And if you have a Plex Pass subscription, you will get access to live TV as well as their DVR feature. Now, the Plex Pass costs about $5 a month, but you can also get an annual pass for $39.99, or do a lifetime pass for $149 and never have to pay again. And then when you have a client that supports live TV or the DVR, you'll start to see a live TV icon show up after you've configured the DVR on the Plex side of things. Now, Plex does require you to install a server. I've covered all this in the past, so I'll link to my big Plex series so you can see exactly how it works. But just like what we saw with the Channels app DVR, Plex runs on just about anything out there for a server too. So I think you shouldn't have a problem finding something to act as your Plex server. So we're gonna go over here to live TV, and we'll scroll back over to the Weather Channel maybe. What it does is it gives you a list of everything that's currently on the air. I can click on the Weather Channel here. It will then tune in and start watching that. What it does do is it runs all of the inbound TV through the Plex server first, where it transcodes it and then puts it back out onto the network. So it might be a little slower than what you saw with the Channels app or InstaTV, but generally things come up right away and you can start watching TV on this thing. Now, at the time that I'm recording this video, you cannot control the DVR recordings from the Apple TV itself. You have to load up a smartphone like an iPhone or an Android phone, use Plex through there to set up your recordings. But after the show is done airing, you can go back and watch the show on your Apple TV here. So I've got a bunch of DVR recordings that I've made on it, and I can play all of these back whenever I want, but you have to wait until the recording is done. There is some time shifting capability with this also on the live TV, but it's disconnected from the recording. So for example, if we go back over here to the Weather Channel, what I can do is pause live TV while it's airing and then rewind in that broadcast, but I can't come back to this later or set it to record while it's on air here. So I can hit the pause button here. It will start queuing up whatever's happening after that, and I can rewind and fast forward. But once I leave this show and pick another one, that little buffer it kept is gone after that. So if I had to choose one of these three right now as the best Apple TV, live TV, and DVR experience, I would have to say the Channels app. It will cost you a little bit more than some of the other solutions we've looked at, but It is probably the most elegant insofar as how well it integrates with the Apple TV. The only downside to it is that it doesn't work easily on other platforms unless you pull up that web interface that I demonstrated earlier. But if you have an Apple TV and have an iPhone and an iPad, and those are your primary devices, the experience is actually very good right now with Channels. They've invested a lot of the money they're making from these apps and their services to make this a really mature platform. And it's come a long way since I first started looking at it. So I'm quite pleased with that. Now, as everything in this space goes, we'll probably see updates and things change over time. So we'll probably revisit the Apple TV in a few months and see what the state of everything is. I'm sure Plex will start adding some additional features in, and we might see the same on InstaTV too. So there are options. You've got a bunch of them, and there are a few things that I haven't covered here on the channel. Part of the problem that I have where I live is that I can't get anything over the air. I have tried, but I get like one channel. So it's hard for me to review some of these other solutions that rely only on over-the-air content. What's nice about the HD Home Run is that it works the same for cable as it does over the air. So even though we were watching a demonstration working off my cable system, if you have one of the HD Home Run over-the-air antennas, your experience would be exactly the same here. So that's going to do it for the Apple TV overview. Let me know down in the comments below if there are things that I missed that I should be looking at. And also let me know what over-the-air solutions you have found that work well with your Apple TV as well. This is Lon Seibin. Thanks for watching.
This channel is brought to you by my Patreon supporters, including Gold Level supporters, the Black Eyed and Blues Music Hour podcast, Chris Allegretta, and Kalyan Kumar. If you want to help the channel, you can by contributing as little as $1 a month. Head over to Lon.TV/Patreon to learn more. And don't forget to subscribe. Visit Lon.TV/S.